Hello guys, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 167. Beyond visual line of sight, trial run for drone delivery of medicine was successfully completed in Bengaluru on Friday. This pilot was led by Throttle Aerospace Systems and Udaan under the supervision of the Director General of Civil Aviation. This trial was conducted within a 15-kilometer radius on the outskirts of Bengaluru by Udaan for the last mile delivery of medicines. During the pilot, two variants of drones were successfully tested, Medcopter X4 and Medcopter X8, with simulated deliveries to Udaan customers. Pharma deliveries of up to 2 kg payload were tested at various distances in the designated area, varying from 2 to 7 km aerial distance. The pilot deliveries saw an average of 3.5 km distance being covered in 5 to 7 minutes. Two different modes of deliveries were also tested: tethered lowering of shipments and landing of copter with the shipment. Apple files many patents. It is not always necessary that product will see daylight anytime soon. The companies will only secure the technology so its competitors cannot use it in the future. Nonetheless, Apple's new patent details a new way through which a specific MacBook key can be used out of the keyboard and used as a mouse. The new patent is titled as Deployable Key Mouse, which was filed with USPTO. The new filing describes a system in which a standard-looking scissor MacBook keyboard houses a hidden removable key. This key would feature a position sensor to be used as a pointed device. And Apple says that the system provides a comfortable, portable, and a precise pointer input for a computer input system. A group of robbers in America have robbed a man of $500,000 in cash using an Apple Watch. This robbery took place last year in Connecticut, but the details of the incident surfaced were made public a couple of days ago. Apple Watch was always regarded as a life-saving device, as there have been too many incidents of the smartwatch alerting users about their serious heart conditions. However, this could be one of the very first incidents where an Apple Watch was used to carry out a robbery. Facebook-owned messaging platform WhatsApp has been working on a multi-device functionality feature for quite some time. This feature will help users in registering WhatsApp accounts on up to 4 linked devices. Now, a new report further hinted that there will be a slight change in the WhatsApp upcoming feature. As per the reports by WhatsApp Beta Information, WhatsApp is currently working on the next iteration of the multi-device functionality feature. Specifically, this new feature will help users when their primary WhatsApp account is linked to an Apple iPad. And he further added that this functionality is not only for iPads but for the Android tablets as well. Android tablets are also planned to support multi-device on WhatsApp for Android. Currently, this feature is still under development and it is expected to be released in future WhatsApp update. Facebook India on Friday announced a new program called the Small Business Loan Initiative. It is in partnership with online lending platform IndieFee to help small and medium businesses that advertise on Facebook to get quick access to credit through the independent lending partners. India is the first country where Facebook is rolling out this program. It is open to businesses registered across 200 towns and cities in India. IndieFee is the first lending partner that Facebook was tied up with, and the program is built with the potential to bring more partners on board. This goal of the initiative is to make business loans more easily accessible to small businesses and reduce the credit gap within India's MSME sector. Beta testers of Google's upcoming Android 12 OS have reported that the Android Auto for phone screen feature has now been replaced by the Google Assistant. Android Auto is not entirely gone, but the new change signals to shift a simpler approach when it comes to an in-car experience. If you are running Android 12, connect to your car's Android Auto and try opening up Android Auto for phone screens on your handset. A pop-up message appears prompting you to try out Google Assistant's driving mode, since Android Auto is now available for car screens. This means that cars that currently run on Android Auto will continue to operate as usual, only the user experience on the phone isn't being changed. However, the new built-in driving experience for Android 12 will offer the same feature for the Android Auto for phone screens, and Google will continue to build on top of that. Google has pointed out that the tech giant is all set to discontinue its current flagship smartphone, the Pixel 5, along with the Pixel 4a 5G, and it is much ahead of the launch of the new Pixel 6 series. Both the models are listed on Google's online store as sold out, and the remaining stock at the other retailers likely won't last long. With the current forecast, we can expect Google store in the US to sell out the Pixel 4a 5G and Pixel 5 in the coming weeks following the launch of Pixel 5a 5G. Wipro HCL Technology and Asian Paints were the new Indian entrants among the top 500 companies in the world. A total of 12 Indian companies featured in the list, which saw India rise above Australia to the 9th position. With the $188 billion, Reliance Industries is the most valuable company, followed by the Tata Consultancy Services about $164 billion and HDFC Bank of $113 billion. Globally, Apple was ranked the most valuable company up 15% to $2.4 trillion. The Big Four were Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, and Alphabet doubled in value since COVID, adding $4 trillion to take their combined value to $8 trillion and making up to 14% to Huron Global 500 most valuable companies. And US led with 243 companies, followed by China with 47 firms. Japan was third with the 30 companies and followed by the UK with 24 companies. T-Mobile US said on Friday an ongoing investigation into a data breach revealed that hackers accessed personal information of an additional 5.3 million customers, bringing the total number of people affected to more than 53 million. The third largest US wireless carrier had earlier this week said that personal data of more than 40 million former and prospective customers was stolen along with the data from 7.8 million existing T-Mobile wireless customers. EVAR Games has announced the second season of Battlegrounds Mobile India Mahayudh. The tournament will feature several top Battlegrounds Mobile India squads as well as 5,000 underdog teams. EVAR Games is collaborating with Upthrust Esports and Gemware for Battlegrounds Mobile India Mahayudh Season 2. The total prize pool of the tournament is 1,50,000 Indian rupees and the top 3 teams will be rewarded with ₹75,000. The top 3 squads will also progress to the next Battlegrounds Mobile India tournament that is hosted by EVAR Games will pick the most valuable player after the tournament, hence who will receive a cash prize. Honor announced the Magic 3 series of smartphones. However, three flagship phones were already available for purchase in China are not only devices Honor has planned to launch this year. The manufacturer is also expected to announce its first foldable smartphone, which will launch as a Magic Fold. While we await for its release, more details regarding this smartphone have been surfaced. Now let's see some of the design features. The Honor Magic Fold will have a cover display that is 6.5 inch in size, which is an inner display will measure 8 inches. It is also expected to come with a Snapdragon 888 Plus processor. Separate subdivisions of famous brand are history as old as the world. Few people are surprised when the parent company introduces its sub-brand and says that the child will surpass the parent. In the case of Honor, initially no one hid that the device of this brand were tailored with the approval and support of Huawei. True, then the parent seems to be watching the new brand from far and tried in every possible way to disown the fact that it was his child. Then it had to sell it as not as to destroy the blood and to allow it to go out of the US sanctions. Honor has continued its journey in the market and it is already ready to give a start in life to the sub-brand itself. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.